some days hurrying by. When you're in love, my, how they fly by. Blue days, all of them gone, nothing but blue skies from now on. Nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue days, all of them gone, nothing but blue skies from now on. Blue skies smiling at me, nothing but blue skies do I see. Days all and gone, nothing but blue skies from now on. Blue skies smiling at me, nothing but blue skies do I see. But blue sky from now on.
Be kindly lying amid the encircling. Was not ever thus, nor prayed that thou shouldst lead me on. I loved to choose and see my path, but now lead thou me on. I loved the garish day, and spite of fears, pride ruled my will. Remember not past years.
So long my path. Till the night.
butcher's dog can't get there.
Who's he?
That's him with his hat. No, he never knew. That dog just talked to me yesterday. He's by me here yesterday. I'm going to call him. Listen, it ain't as good as it used to be.
Why not?
Well, people don't live like they used to. They go to church on Saturdays and Sundays and Wednesday nights. And then when church time's over, they get out, and I've seen a lot of them have to come out to be drinking and smoking their cigarettes. Well, ain't no way the Lord wants you to live.
You ever drink or smoke?
I never drank a drop of whiskey, beer, and a cigarette, and never drank no coffee in my lifetime.
Ever?
Never did. No, ma'am, I never did. And I don't believe in cussing. I don't cuss nothing. I don't get mad. When I get mad, I don't cuss and riot. I laugh when I'm mad. When I'm mad, I laugh.
Why do you do that?
Well, it better be that way until you be mad. What do you want to be mad about? Ain't nothing to be mad about, is it?
I don't really.
A lot of people got ways I don't like, but I don't hate nobody. I don't hate nobody, but some people got ways I don't like, but I don't hate them. Well, I don't get mad and cuss and call it do me dirty, you know. Old saying is, I just laugh it off and go ahead. In my home, even my daddy was a preacher. Charlie Ford was kind of be a good preacher that ever lived, and he lived it. But he didn't preach, you know, on Saturdays and Sundays. He preached every day. Every day. He preached every day. And said that's what he's supposed to do. He said, supposed to live every day the same. You know what he told me? He said, don't try to be no preacher. I said, why? He said, well, if you're going to be one. He said, don't try to be one. He told me not to try to be one, you know, because if you said that, you said you can fool people here on earth, but said you can't fool the Lord. That's what he told me. So I listened to that. I listened to that what he said.
What kind of preacher was he?
He was a Baptist. He was a Baptist.
Around where?
Well, he didn't have no round where to it. He just had a little place built out on the place where had church every day there on his own plow, on my own place. We lived up in the mountains, like, you know, hills in Kentucky.
Where?
Up around the little place they call Haddon or something like it. I can't speak of me like you can. I got my mother, Cherokee Indian, you see. And I take back at the Indians whole lot doing and other people. And
did you learn a lot from your mother too?
No, because I'll tell you why. She didn't go to church like he did. I know he's Milan. I know he's Milan. She didn't go to church like he did. He went every day, but he didn't. And I didn't learn too much from her because I didn't stay where she sat too much. I ain't going to lie about it.
You didn't do what?
I didn't stay around my mother too much. See, after I got 12 years old, me and my stepbrother, we left from his daddy and my daddy, and we lived in vagabonds and places. The only when daytime coming, he had church, I'd go and listen to it. And I'll tell you the funniest joke is, I had an aunt, you know, she was kind of like my mother. She didn't go to church too much. And she used to chew this old snuff, you know. And she'd go into church, and my father would be preaching. She'd spit right down the aisle. And you see, when they have them up there, you know, there, and they dance, they get them dance, you know, they have a dance, you know, when they have the church, you know, what I mean, kind of a holy dance, you see, what I mean, a holy dance.
No, what do you mean?
Well, you see, they get happy and get up and dance, you know, on the floor, you know, a little bit, you know.
Everybody?
Yeah, all of them would, yeah. No, I didn't, I ain't gonna lie about it. And I had an aunt with her, and she would sit there and laugh and make fun of them. And when they do that, she would spit down in front of them, you know. And she had a hat pin, you know, in her head, in her hat. I got that pin out and I stuck her in the hip with it. And boy, she jumped up and they thought she got happy, you see.
Why, Ernie?
I'm just telling you the truth. You want me to tell you the truth? I'm going to tell you the truth.
Yeah, I asked for it, didn't I?
You asked for it. And so I went to say, well, after I done that, you know what? She did get saved. They thought she was. Never went back out pet dog, you know, thought she was doing like they were doing things, you know, but she's doing that and I can't pin her, you know, when I stuck her.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
And So from that on, well, my aunt, her name was Mary Hazelwood, her name was, you know.
Well, the Lord works in mysterious ways. Maybe you did say
yeah, that. And I done a paper there for her. From that on, she got so she come out of church, she would throw out there the cud out of her mouth, you know. She'd chew this old snuff, you know. And it looked like one of my goats, you know, chewing the cud. When they belch it up, you know, and chew it, you see, that's the way they do, you know. They take and swallow it whole, and they belch it up when they lay around and chew it up. And that's what I thought she was doing, like a goat. And so... But from that on, I can say one thing, she was the nicest woman I ever met.
Do you still believe in God?
Yes, ma'am, I always do. He's first of all.
What's your idea of God?
Because I'm going to meet him someday. I'm going to meet him, and he's going to say to me, I know you. He ain't going to do like he said to the woman one time, you know, in the Bible. You see, when you read the Bible, you know, where he said to the woman, that don't know, you see. And he, like the woman that he said to her, said, you're living with a man, but ain't your husband. I want to be different to that. I want to be, when he see me, he said, come on home. See, that's when I say this ain't my home here. This is this workshop here. My home's up yonder. Now, and I don't care if you go see it. It's the worst looking place you ever seen, but I don't care. But as old saying is, this is not my home. I just, well, yeah, I was ready to tell you, I stay out in the yard. I mean, in the summertime, I stay out with animals.
This is just temporary.
That's right. And it's the worst looking place in Franklin County. But I have more people come here and see this old place than you ever think about. From all, you know, from, well, I'll let you see the license on there, where to leave the license before to leave on my, on the card. And I started coming, I come here to Franklin County, just me and a dog. And I had on just my clothes. And I met a fellow with the police. And me and him been friends for 20 years. And as Mr. Hossie has been good to me, you ever seen as any man could be to me in 20 years. And so he told me, he said, going down in Frankfurt, said, me going down in Frankfurt, I can make it. And so I went on down in Frankfurt, and he don't, I didn't know what, see, I didn't know what time that you could call and talk to anybody, you know, like you did there, you know. And so he called the jailer and told the jailer I was coming. And the jailer was outside waiting for me to come down, you see. So I walked upside this jailer, and I asked him, I said, what can a fella do, maybe there's something to be put in jail for the night so he wouldn't have to stay out in the weather of the night, it was snowing. He said, oh, hit somebody. Well, I hit the jailer. I hit him. So we then asked him, would he do something bad? He said, no, I said, I asked for that. I said, well, I'm going to hit you again. He said, well, come on, follow me. So he took me around and put me in jail. So I never told this jailer my name or nothing. So next morning, he come and said, Tennessee Aaron Ford, get out. I said, go see the judge. Well, I thought you were going to make me pay for it, you know, for hitting him. I put him back in jail. I didn't care because at the end I wanted to play sleep in, you know. And so he told me, he said, go see him. When I'm seeing the city judge, he said, you like to work today? That was on Monday morning. I said, yes, sir, I'd like to work. And I've been working ever since.
Do you like to work?
Yes, ma'am. I just do that and would sit around, or lay around, like some people. I had a fellow said the other day, he's up there 60 years old, and he's been as good a worker as I ever seen on earth, this man had. And you know what he told me? He said, now, said, I'm retiring, I ain't going to work no more. And so, that's about a month ago, and today, I mean, yesterday, I seen him yesterday, he can hardly walk. He said, quit working, he's getting so he can't walk. So he said, he's going to go back to work.
What's your secret of staying healthy all the time like you are?
Well, one thing, leave in the Lord. Yeah, and he'll take care of you. He's the best doctor you can have. These doctors, they're just like the preachers. They're looking for money. And if they ain't got money, well, they can't do you no good.
So you just bypass the doctors and the preachers both?
Yep. I don't hate preachers.
No?
I don't hate the preachers, don't hate the doctors. But I don't want their medicine, and I don't want them preaching to me.
Do you take any kind of medicine at all?
No, ma'am, don't take none. Never? I ain't taken none since I was 12 years old. And then my aunt, I stayed with my aunt for a while. She used to give me medicine, and when she turned her head, I'd throw it back behind me so she wouldn't see what I'd done with it. Ain't a lot of time.
Why'd you do that?
I didn't want to take it.
How come?
Well, I believe in the Lord. Because, you see, my father told you if you believe in the Lord, he'd take care of you and keep you going. And so I believe in him. And that's the reason I come here on the hillside. I know it's the worst looking place almost in Franklin County. But I love it.
Did your mother, being a Cherokee Indian, did she ever give you any herbal remedies or use any herbs or any
I wasn't ready to do that, if you want me to tell you the truth.
You didn't that you left when you were when 12?
Well, I'm 12 years old. See, then, because I'll tell you why. Now, you can say what you want to. She was a good woman, I understand. I ain't saying she wasn't a good woman, but she just didn't go to church like she should. You see, if, you know, if two people together, when they're supposed to be married together and be together, they ought to pull with one another. They're like a horse. You take a team of horses, one pull one way and one another, you can't pull your load no horse. And so he had all the load to carry, you see, if you want me to tell you about going to church.
What became?
Huh?
You ever been sick?
No, sir. Not sick enough to have one of them doctor anything. I tell you the truth. But I've been hungry now, understand? And I've been hungry and thirsty.
Lonely?
And lonely, yes, ma'am. I ain't gonna lie about that. I've been that away. And I lost a lot of weight this summer. You know, but not having money to do it like I want to have, but because I'm trying to get me a place fixed here, so I'll be happy, and I'm happy with it. Animals, I love animals. I love animals, I love little, well, I love people too, I understand, grown people, but more, I love little children more than do anything else.
Have you ever had any children?
One, and he died when he was about 4 years old.
4 years old. Did you ever take care of any others or have any live with you?
Yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. I've had them live with me and took care of them. And I tell you, she's dead and gone now, but I don't know whether you ever know it or not, hear anybody talk about it or not, but people around the health department know her. There's a woman, she used to be old and crippled up and couldn't hardly walk. I forget her name, but she's nice you ever seen. I live in, down there in Frankfurt, down there. It's in a two-room house, and she brought me three little children to take care of them. I kept them for about 3 or 4 years down there, and then I took care of others that way. And the woman I used to be married to, I took care of her children, raised them up big enough to take care of them, too. And I'll show you a picture of one of them that I took care of. I'll show you some pictures in the house, some others I took care of.
Now, you've been on television before.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you think about yourself on television?
Well, this is the way I look at it. You can say what you want to, but anyway, look at it, I ain't no better on television than I am off television. I didn't say it that way.
Far away in the depths of my spirit tonight rose a melody sweeter than sound. In celestial like strains it unceasingly falls o'er my soul like an infinite calm.
Peace, peace, wonderful peace, coming down from the Father above. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray, in fathomless billows of love. What a treasure I have in this wonderful peace, buried deep in the heart of my soul, so secure that no power can mine it away while the years of eternity roll. Peace, peace, wonderful peace, coming down from the Father.